America is the birthplace of the internet and a world leader in high-tech innovation. But what many Americans don't realize is that over the last several years, America's internet leadership has actually been falling. And a growing digital divide has opened up between Americans who do have access and choice and those who don't. Americans like El Monte, California's Michael Ibarra.
It's pretty much true that none of the people around here actually have internet, just like one or two, and probably or five out of this whole neighborhood probably have internet around here.
And actually we couldn't afford it, but he needs it. Sometimes he gets angry because he's got to go to the neighbors to borrow them or to the library if there's room, because here the library you can get access to them because there's kids like him. A lot of them don't have it. I know we need it. I know he needs it desperately because, you know, his school, he goes to a private school. He got a scholarship, so he needs it because they do a lot of things. And then I can get no emails or nothing. They think like I'm from the backwoods that I don't.
And the Ibarras are not alone. Only about half of all U.S. households are connected to high-speed internet. And the divide of those without that broadband access falls mostly along class, geography, and racial lines. 66 to 82% of households earning more than $50,000 a year have a broadband connection. But less than half as many lower-income households can say the same. And while 55% of white households have high-speed internet, less than 36% of minority households are connected. And the gap is growing between urban and rural America as well. And when it comes to choice, the U.S. has fallen far behind other developed nations. A big part of the problem is the lack of real competition among broadband providers in local markets. With few real choices, Americans are left paying much more for connections that are far slower than what's available in Western Europe and Asia. So instead of one nation online, there are increasingly two Americas, one with digital opportunity and one without.
That's why InternetForEveryone.org held town hall meetings online and across the country, asking everyday citizens what they thought about how America can help get affordable internet access to all. Their recommendations? Government should create better incentives for those seeking to build new networks, like grants, tax incentives, and subsidies, and should treat broadband as a public utility, like electricity, water systems, and roads. Federal legislation should be established to ensure universal access and user choice. And local communities should be free to build their own networks, like municipal wireless and fiber, and establish technology centers. To help spread access to jobs, news and information, and educational opportunity, just like it has for the Ibarra family.
The reason why I'm in this private school is because of my big brother. He found out about better schools and wanted me to get a better education. And he got all that information from the internet.
Yes, if it weren't for the internet, he wouldn't have been able to go to the school he was, because he was doing real good in school, and his big brother said, Margaret, he deserves a better than public school. Maybe he got on the internet and he found the scholarship.